discussing news and issues in orthopedics and spine healthcare. This is Spine Talk.
Hi, I'm Dr. John Shim, and today we're going to talk about a very interesting topic, and that's the topic about disc degeneration findings on MRIs of young military recruits of the Italian Air Force. There was a study published in June 2019 in one of the journals of spine, and it's about this very topic. Jason, I hope you can kind of enlighten us on the topic and what they found.
All right. So this study, a very intriguing study that we looked at, comes to us from Naples, Italy. It was a cross-sectional study, retrospective study of 350 Air Force cadets in Italy. The cadets ranged in age from 18 to 22 years old. All of them underwent an MRI of the thoracic and lumbar spine. This was done over approximately a four-year period. The study protocol had two radiologists reviewing the studies to look at curve abnormalities, structural abnormalities, spinal canal diameter, and degenerative and spinal cord abnormalities. And the findings of this study kind of probably surprised some, is that 77% of the 350 cadets had some form of a structural abnormality. This includes 49% with a disc bulge and 38% with some type of alteration of the spinal curve and 30% with disc desiccation. The authors of the study concluded that the imaging findings are similar to that of an adult population and suggest the aging spine is morphologically appreciable in immediate post-adolescent period. So Dr. Shim, based on the kind of the findings of the study, do the findings at all kind of surprise you for this very young cohort?
Well, for me, it's not a surprise. People have to understand, we see a very skewed population. People come to see a spinal specialist like me because they're having pain. They don't come to me because they're not having pain. So when we get tests, it's almost rare that we ever see a normal MRI. What does give me pause is the number of these young, healthy cadets, age 18 to 22, actually has some sort of finding abnormal on the MRI, 77%. That's three-fourths of the population who are not having concerns had these findings. Slightly higher than what I thought, but this is more in light of what we kind of know now. The natural history is people develop these degenerative findings or these findings on their MRIs, and we see them all the time.
So 77% of this population had an abnormal finding despite being asymptomatic, yet we know that about 80% of the population, the adult population, develops back pain at some point in their life. As a clinician, where do you draw the line and say that the changes that we see on an MRI are truly age-related versus some type of precipitating event causing them?
Well, you know, the statistic about 80% of people having some significant debilitating spinal concern in their life, that's pretty much accepted principle. The question is, how many of those complaints are actually related to a disc problem, or how much is related to the normal wear and tear of arthritis in the spine, or how much is related to pulls of ligaments and tendons and muscles of the spine? I think there's a combination of all those things. MRIs are a very significant diagnostic study. It gives us a lot of information. The question is it giving us information that's relevant to that person who's getting the MRI? If there's some sort of event that happened and you're really concerned, you get x-rays, you see findings, I think the MRI is very, very helpful. The physical exam will clue you in on should there be a major finding on the MRI. So I think you have to take the MRI findings a little grain of salt. You have to put it together with what's going on with that person, what happened to that person, and what are the physical exam findings. Do they have numbness? Do they have weakness to their muscles that we can detect? Do they have reflex changes that we can detect? That would clue us in on, are these MRI findings actually related to what's going on with that person right now?
Okay. So for the purpose of the study here, so again, it's really not clear from reading through the paper a couple times here, kind of the overall intended purpose of this. You know, this kind of looks like they want to use this as a screening tool, in this case for cadets going into the Air Force. So when you tell an 18 to 22 year old that you have some type of issue with your spine, again, they're not having necessarily any pain, but there's findings on the MRI, what does this do for the long term? Meaning, are we going to spend thousands and thousands of dollars? We already know billions of dollars are spent yearly on healthcare for spine-related disorders. Are those people more likely to be the ones that consume all the healthcare dollars because they know early in life there's a problem with their spine.
Well, I mean, you bring up a very interesting point, and I'm not sure this has really been researched because most of the research that we have in medicine is geared towards trying to solve a problem, all right? A lot of the research is actually fostered by entities that produce pharmaceutical or medicines, produce devices to try to help people. So in a way, a lot of these researchers are geared towards finding a problem that we can fix. What we're saying is there's a problem identified on a test that may not be the source of the complaint, but now have we embedded a potential source of anxiety? My goodness, I'm 22 years old and I have these findings in my spine. What's it gonna do to me long term? Is that gonna cause more utilization of healthcare services down the road? Right. Is that gonna cause more angst and maybe increasing rates of disability and work injuries, whatnot? I don't know if the data is really out there yet, but from a practical standpoint, I think it probably does. There probably needs to be some longitudinal research on that being done. But I can't really say for sure if enough information has been provided for us to be able to make those conclusions.
Right. Now, overall, again, it's a very intriguing study. There are a lot of kind of questions the study can raise, but I think it's definitely some eye-opening statistics that this group of authors came up with in looking at the MRI findings.
Well, I'll tell you, in the past, historically in the 60s, we used to x-ray people's backs before they're hired for some manual labor jobs and whatnot. Well, they stopped doing that because they realized x-ray findings by themselves do not really have bearing on how well a person will perform in their job functions, even heavy labor functions. So I'm not sure using this as a screening tool to take people out of contention for certain things actually makes sense. I don't know if this would pass muster in the United States, maybe pass muster in Italy. What I do know is we still don't know a lot about the unintended consequences of testing. To give you an example, there's a lot of information now on laboratory testing. We know if you get a 20 laboratory tests, there's a 5% chance at any one of those laboratories being abnormal just because it's abnormal by testing. Mm-hmm. So one out of 20 findings is going to be abnormal. Then you have to chase that finding to find out if that's real or not. Well, it turns out we increase the level of anxiety for a lot of these folks, and there is studies showing that there's overutilization based on testing. So is that overutilization of MRI testing actually causing long-term costs, which I think it does? Mm-hmm. More important, is it causing long-term psychological anxieties and predisposing people to be concerned about things they shouldn't be concerned about? This is very, very important issues. I wish we had the answers. I think more studies need to be done. The question is, who's going to fund those studies, and is there an incentive to fund those studies?
All right.
So this is Dr. Shim and Jason Mazza. We're talking about the study. It's called the High Prevalence of Spinal Magnetic Resonance Imaging Findings in Asymptomatic Young Adults Age 18 to 22, Cadets to an Air Force Flight. This was published in the Journal of Spine in June of 2019. I found it kind of interesting. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. If you'd like to find out more information about our videos, please subscribe to our station. Thank you.